So what is going on everybody, my name is Mehul and welcome to your 42nd Android application development tutorial, in which I'm going to show you how to add functionality to these buttons right there. And you might have noticed that we are missing the period button, which would have been useful to work with floating point numbers. But I realized that it would just kind of extend the number of tutorials, but wouldn't do a lot of, you know, it wouldn't require a lot of things from Android because it just requires some sort of logic or algorithm implementation. But there's nothing sort of learning Android in that particular implementation. So I'm just gonna leave that because that would just, you know, add to our time. And you know, it would just make our code a little bit more complex, nothing much. So you can just try it yourself if you want to, but I'm just skipping over that. So I'm just gonna implement these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 buttons, and after these 5 button implementation you could probably just implement the square root as well. So what we need to do first is that actually I have assigned this operation method right here to all these 5 buttons for now, excluding the square root, and we have this operation method right here. So what I'm gonna do in this operation method is that I'm just gonna get this same thing button, then I'm gonna say string op is my operation, which would be b dot get text dot toString. Then I again need number, but let's just change variable names so that you know, it doesn't create any sort of conflict. So last num should be good, and we need to declare this as long here. Then finally what we need is we need to check for various operations. Right now this could be actually a little bit weird to do in a single function. It could just extend the length, so we can just chop it down into various functions, or for now at least just one function. So again we need to just get a variable result, and what our approach would be is actually I'm just targeting the small display from this line which we added in the last tutorial. So what our approach would be is that we would be adding the number or, you know, whatever associated operation into this small display, and then when the user finally presses equal to, then we would display the main result into the main field. Otherwise we'll just display it in the top right number plate or whatever you call that. So what I want to do here is actually say that result equals calculate, and then what to calculate here. Well, I want to calculate the result from the result itself, because remember that we would be, you know, kind of making sure that the result variable is up to date. And then I need the last num to perform some operations, and what operation? I need the operation one. And there's a slight problem here, that right now with op variable what we are doing is that we are passing the current operations. So for example, if the user presses equal to, then what would happen is that this op would contain an equal to symbol, and let me just show you what would actually happen instead. So let's just create a function, public void calculate, and then just say that it accepts long result, long last num, and then string op, right? And then I'm just gonna quickly say that if op equals plus, then what I want to do is return result plus last num, else if, and actually this should be long instead of void, else if op equals negative, then return result minus last num, else if op equals multiply, times, else if OP equals divide, and otherwise I'm pretty sure that the equal to button is pressed, so I just want to return the result so that you know, when the equal to button is pressed again on a particular number, we don't actually just misbehave, we just keep the number right there. So the problem with this button, with this approach right here, is that whenever you are on a calculator screen, like you know, just leave that. So let's just say if you open like if you write like 5, then you press plus, right? Then if you write 3, then you press equal to. Then for this calculation, what happens is that for the result, the OP is equal to, so instead of doing result plus last num, which would be 5 plus 3, it would simply return us result. So what we need to do is actually pass in this plus instead of this equal to inside OP. So we need to actually store the last operator used. So for that, what we can do is say that we create a string here, last OP, and let's just set it to equal to, just in case a person, instead of doing any operation, just presses equal to, so that our program doesn't crash. Right, so now instead of this OP, I'm gonna pass in last OP here. Now we need to set our small display value as well, so let's just make sure that we don't forget that. So small display dot set text, and this would be string dot value of, and this would be result, and then I would just like to add the current operator as well, so that we could just see what is happening with our result. Right, so, and one more task that is left is that we need to create public void clear view v, and we need this view v argument for this call right there, by this call. So what I'm gonna do is say display dot set text as 0, actually not blank. So what we can do is that we can just call in clear right there and pass in null, and it would just clear whenever there's a operation tab, so that we could just give some space to user for entering new number. Right, so yeah, so let's just test this out, and actually no, not yet, because we are not doing anything when the equal to button is pressed. So what I want to do is say if OP equals equal to, then what I want to do is say that display dot set text is a string dot value of result, and last num should fall back to 0 and result should fall back to 0, so that we can just get a fresh clean start. And looks pretty cool now, and let's just see if this works or not. And right here we are, 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 equals 3. Okay, so it's kinda like we are not getting our last result as you know, as the return value, because if I clear this and say 1 plus 1 equals, it gives me 1 instead of 2, so we are missing a number. And the reason for that could be, actually the reason could be that actually we are not setting it to 0, because right here on the first go, this value is kind of nothing, right? So we need to actually make sure that this is 0. So if I do like 1 plus 1 plus 1 equals, and it gives me again 2 actually, And let's just try to reinstall the app. Maybe it's actually we could just do right here. We can just set small display dot set text as 0 so that we could just verify the code was updated or not. And if I say now 1 plus 1 plus 1 equals, it gives me again 2, so there's some sort of problem with our code only. Okay, so we could probably just debug it. So I can say this is custom tag which we are making use of, so this would be last number and this would be string dot value of last name. Similarly, we have this as our result, right? And okay, so let's just see what happens now. And if I press 1 2 plus, we get last number as 12 and result number as 0. Okay. Oh, okay, so actually we should return last number here instead of result. Well, that was a lot of a bug. Okay, so anyways, now if I enter 12 plus 12 looks fine. 24 plus 5 equals 29. Perfect. Okay, so now we have implemented this thing, right? And if I do like 5 times 3 plus 5, it gives me 20, because 15 plus 5 is 20. Okay, now the problem is that what happens when I try to switch signs without entering a number? Like if I do like 5, or actually clear this first, 5 plus, and if I do like minus, plus, minus, pretty cool. But the problem arises with these two. If I do multiplication and if I then switch with plus, you can see that my digit changes to 0. And the reason is that this last number becomes 0 when I press op equals x, then it returns result times 0, that becomes 0. So after pressing that multiplication, whatever I do, the result, my result is actually 0. So to fix this, what we need to do is actually we need to keep a track of this thing again, if the button is clicked without pressing any number or if it is clicked after pressing some number. So we just fix that thing in the next tutorial, because that is all for this one. And if you liked it, then don't forget to subscribe, and thank you for watching. I'll see you then in the next one.